Hello and welcome to NewsClick. Today we are going to discuss about the upcoming elections of Punjab. To discuss the issue, we have with us Professor Chaman Lal. So welcome to NewsClick, sir. We have seen that Punjab has become a triangular fight now between Aam Aadmi Party, Congress and Shiromani Akali Dal and BJP. So what do you think, what would be the outcome of this triangular fight?
Actually, it's very difficult to say at the moment. It looked like about few months ago, as if AAP has a sort of edge over others. But few months, happenings within the AAP and outside the AAP has somewhat changed the situation. So at the moment, it's difficult to say whether Congress has an upper hand or AAP has an upper hand. But still, it looks like AAP has slight edge over others.
So you mean to say that Shiromani Akali Dal and BJP are not coming back technically? It's fight between Congress and AAP.
Actually, out of this election, BJP as single party would be the biggest sufferer in my opinion. Because Akalis may come with certain seats, but BJP may not be able to, get. Last time they were 12. Still last time they had got 19 out of 23. But this time they are hoping to retain 12. But I don't think that they will be able to retain that. They may get reduced to 3, 4, 5 or whatever.
So what do you think? What's the reason behind this setback to BJP especially?
No, what happens is... BJP's main, area of influence is towns and with the, small businessmen, etc. In both these areas, AAP has cut down them. And even Congress has revived certain influence over them. And with this demonetization and all that, that will certainly, hit them.
So, but if we look at the Chandigarh elections recently, the local body elections, BJP has gained a lot of seats there.
They won in Chandigarh, but Chandigarh is different than the other part of Punjab. But Chandigarh is not as such part of Punjab as yet, although it's considered to be, it should have been a part of Punjab. Chandigarh is a different kind of thing. Chandigarh is a middle-class area and moreover, influenced by media a lot. And then generally what happens in local elections, the ruling party always has an advantage. So that's how they have got, But in other parts of Punjab, they do not have that much kind of sympathy or anything.
So what do you think, what are the core issues on which this elections would be fought?
As these should have been attended to. The biggest thing, although the drug problem is getting this kind of center focus, but drug problem is a symptom. Drug problem is not the root problem. Root problem is unemployment among youth and frustration among youth, not having any positive outlet for life, and that takes them to drugs. So nobody, all out of all these three parties, none of them is paying much attention to that. And second most crucial problem is peasantry's indebtedness.
There's an agrarian crisis.
Yeah, peasantry is in a serious crisis. Actually, Punjab is the, I think, number two or three state where every day peasants are committing suicides. Every day. Outside Punjab, I don't know whether how many people know about it because the national papers do not even publish that news. But Punjab papers, every day on front page, there is a news of one or two peasants committing suicide because of indebtedness. Now, people, these political parties have become just used to that. They have a kind of cliche about it. And none is paying any serious attention. And this government, central government particularly, and even the earlier government also, Manmohan Singh government also, they're so insensitive to the peasantry that none of them, and AAP was expected to focus on this issue, but AAP is also now, for the last few months, whatever they are doing in Punjab, that is not much different from what Akali or Congress or BJP is doing. All same kinds of floor crossing, getting people from Akalis to AAP, or getting from Congress to AAP, or even from BJP to AAP. But there is no kind of moral or political standards being maintained by all three parties.
So if we look at the condition today, it looks like Congress is the strongest force among all these three parties. So it's merely anti-incumbency, or it's something else also?
You see, anti-incumbency is certainly there, because the last 10 years, they have, kind of looted Punjab. They have used government to promote their business interests. Well, it's a very, sad part of the thing. And this is perhaps worst in Punjab. I don't think that in other places, maybe in Karnataka, the Northern Delhi kind of thing, people, Yadurappa kind of people have been doing this. But here, the whole, the hotel industry, the transport industry, this being Badal's family business, which is being promoted with the state support, which they're holding the power. And that is the one part which people feel so, upset and offended.
So when we talk about all these three parties, what we forget is that BSP had a strong presence in Punjab, and also the left parties. Do you think they will be any important force?
No, actually, BSP could never become strong in Punjab. In one election in 1992, when major parties, major one party, Akalis, boycotted the election. That was the only year when there was just 30% or so, voting. That time they have won about 9 MLAs. But other than that, and there was one election in which they won about 2 MPs also, 2 or 3 MPs, just one or two elections. Other than that, and that time Kanshiram was alive. Kanshiram actually had won from Punjab once. This people's lives are getting to such a degrading, and there the left should have been the people's voice. But in Punjab, sadly, left is almost stand nowhere. There are 4 parties, small level, CPM, one splinter group of CPM, which is now called as RMPI, Revolutionary Marxist Party of India. Then CPI, then CPI ML, Liberation. These 4 parties had a kind of a front. But now in this election, the four-party front has been sustained. And these 3 parties are together. ML is not part of that. There are certain left groups which generally do not participate. They are campaigning for NOTA. So they are mass peasant groups which are helping the peasantry in crisis. But that is also a very limited kind of, what they do is Bharatiya Kisan Union. There are 2-3 groups. One is Ekta, one is Ugraha, and they are very radical groups. And what they do when there is some peasant commit suicide, they build a huge movement and they get a relief for their family, 5-10 lakh rupees. That's the only way they are trying to help them. But in election, they keep aloof, or they are, going for nota. Now, that is the mass-based groups which should have been, approached by the left front. And these 4 should have remained together. They should have tried to get along up some splinter groups which have a progressive background, that is like Patiala's MP, Dr. Dharamveer Gandhi, etc. They should have formed a broad-based front, and they should have concentrated upon to have a presence in the assembly. Even if the smaller number of people were there, that should have been given them certain credibility. If they have got 5-7 MLAs in the assembly, and they have been able to raise you know, peasantry issues, youth issues, that should have made people feel that, yes, they are our real, you know, hamdard or something, real sympathizers.
That's all the time we have for today, sir, and we'll be coming back to you on such issues. Thanks a lot.
Okay.
Thank you for watching NewsClick and keep following us.